In some situations, it makes more sense to control a peripheral with a deterministic, dedicated processor rather than a general-purpose ARM core. Applications range from a dedicated overvoltage monitoring system, where the processor load can be offloaded from the ARM, to a real-time industrial environment, where stimulus requires a response from the processor in a known amount of time. My name is Nick, and today we are going to explore how to use the PRU core to control a peripheral on any TI processor with a PRU-ICSS or PRU-ICSSG. For more information and training material about the PRU, refer to the PRU-ICSS wiki at the link shown. First, we will look into the general process of using the PRU to control a peripheral. Then, we will illustrate that process by walking through the template project PRU-ADC-on-chip, which was written for the Sitara AM335X processor running on a Beaglebone Black board. Let's start by discussing the general process of controlling a peripheral with the PRU. In many cases, you only want one core interacting with the peripheral. If that is the case, make sure that you disable your other cores from accessing the peripheral. For example, in Linux, you can disable the ARM from accessing the ADC by setting the ADC as disabled in the device tree file. Next, you need to load firmware into the PRU's instruction RAM, or IRAM. Texas Instruments Linux and RTOS operating systems both have tools that allow the ARM to initialize the PRU. Then, the PRU must initialize the peripheral, since the other cores think that the peripheral is not being used. First, the PRU must make sure that the clock sources for the peripheral are turned on. Then, the PRU can set the required registers within the peripheral to initialize it. At this point, the PRU is ready to control the peripheral however your system needs it to. We will now take a deeper look at the PRU-ADC on-chip project. The PRU-ADC on-chip project contains code that the user uses to interact with the ARM processor and firmware that is loaded into the PRU-ICSS. All of the project-specific information covered in this video can be found in the project's README file. We will start by analyzing what the software in PRU-ADC on-chip is doing. If PRU-0 has not been initialized, the ARM takes the name of the PRU firmware that should be loaded into the PRU, and the ARM specifies that name through the SysFS interface. Then, the ARM uses the SysFS interface to tell RemoteProc to initialize the PRU. RemoteProc configures any resources that the firmware requests, which, in this case, is V-rings in DDR for RPMsg communication. RemoteProc sets up the PRU interrupt mapping, loads the firmware into the PRU's instruction memory, and instructs the PRU cores to begin execution. An RPMsg character driver is created that the ARM can use to communicate with the PRU later. For more information on RemoteProc, take a look at the RemoteProc and RPMsg reference page. In our example, the ADC is controlled by the PRU and considered disabled by the Linux ARM core. That means that the PRU is in charge of initializing the ADC. First, the PRU enables the ADC clock so that the PRU can write to the ADC registers. Then, the PRU disables the ADC module so that the ADC can be programmed. The ADC samples an input voltage during a step. That means the PRU must set up the ADC step configuration registers. Our example uses one-shot mode, which means that the ADC will only perform one measurement in a particular step before disabling that step. Finally, the PRU enables the ADC module. When the PRU wants to read a value from an ADC channel, first it checks that the ADC data FIFO is empty. Then, the PRU enables the step that we configured to sample the requested ADC input channel. The PRU waits for the channel voltage value to get written into the data FIFO. Finally, the PRU reads the value that was written into the data FIFO. In PRU ADC on-chip, users pass the number of the ADC channel they want to read into the ARM. The ARM writes the ADC channel number to the PRU's RPMsg character driver. The ARM then waits for a reply RPMsg message to appear in the character driver. The PRU waits for an RPMsg message from the ARM. When it receives a message, it reads the requested ADC channel. The PRU then sends the voltage value back to the ARM in a reply RPMsg message. For more information on RPMsg, take a look at the remote proc and RPMsg reference page. Now, let's proceed to the demonstration. First, we will set up the hardware. Take your BeagleBone Black and connect voltages that you want to measure to your ADC channels 5, 6, and 7. In my setup, I have created a voltage divider between the board's ADC VDD and ADC ground. I connected the ADC ground to channel 5, the voltage divider output to channel 6, and the ADC VDD to channel 7. Note that ADC voltages must not exceed 1.8 volts. I also connected a serial FTDI cable to a header that I populated on the back side of the board. Next, we will need to install the software required to run the demonstration. The code required for this example can be found in the PRU software support package, version 5.4.0 and later, which is included in Processor SDK Linux 5.2 and later. The software support package also includes example code for many other basic PRU tasks. After that, you build the output files and load them onto the BeagleBone Black, as detailed in the PRU ADC on-chip readme.txt file. We will now go through the steps to run PRU ADC on-chip. We run PRU ADC user space. I pass in C5 in order to tell the PRU to read from ADC channel 5. This is the first time the application was run after the board booted up, so the ARM had to initialize the PRU before it could pass in the channel number through RPMsg. The output new RPMsg PRU device tells us that the RPMsg character driver used to communicate with the PRU was successfully created. The ARM reports that the voltage measured on ADC channel 5 is 0.0004 volts. The AM335X on-chip ADC uses a 12-bit measurement to represent up to 1.8 volts. So that means the ADC gave us a measurement of 1 out of 4,095. My test environment was electrically noisy with long wires, so this value is possible, even though it is not exactly 0 volts. Let's clear the screen so the rest of our results are easier to see. I will once again test channel 5. Remember, we expect this value to be 0 volts. This time, the voltage on channel 5 is measured as exactly 0 volts. Now, I will request the voltage on ADC channel 6. The voltage measured on ADC channel 6 is 0.902 volts. I used resistors with a 5% tolerance to create a 50% voltage divider. So, 0.902 volts makes sense. Finally, I will request the voltage on channel 7. We expect this value to be 1.8 volts. The voltage measured on ADC channel 7 is 1.7991 volts. That means the ADC gave us a voltage of 4,093 out of 4,095. The voltage could have dropped slightly over the long wires between the 1.8 volt voltage source and ADC channel 7, so a value slightly under 1.8 volts does make sense. Finally, the results of the application may be validated by measuring the voltage at the ADC inputs with a multimeter. This concludes the demonstration for PRU ADC on chip. For more information, refer to the links shown. Thank you for taking the time to watch this presentation. If you have any questions, please post them on the Texas Instruments E2E forum.